Negros no longer needs coal, and it's not going to help us in any way. We're calling for the government to declare Negros coal-free. Our initiatives is creating a youth coalition called Youth for Climate Hope. It's composed of various youth groups promoting renewable energy. Right now, what we're focusing on is the fight versus coal. So the proposed coal plant is in San Carlos City. We're fighting here in Bacolod because the provincial government is here.
We've started on the first day of January. We had a silent demonstration also in front of the provincial government of Negros Occidental, where we held up a banner that said coal-free Negros, having silent demonstrations in front of the provincial government every Wednesday, because the Sangguniang Panalawigan sessions occur every Wednesday at 3 p.m. So we will be there by 4 p.m. hopefully when they finish the session, so that they can see the stand of the youth and they can see that we are united and one in this advocacy.
Together with Youth for Climate Hope, we drafted a program to help empower them in their campaigning. We talked about the basics of coal science and climate science, campaigning, power mapping, stakeholder analysis, security, and tools that 350.org can offer the young activists here in Bacolod and here in Negros. We have digital tools that we can use to amplify the calls of the local groups. In the huge fight that is climate change, it's important to remember that we are not alone, that this is not an isolated fight, and that globally there are multiple fights against fossil fuel plants all around the world, and that it's important to link these actions together to show the fossil fuel industry that people power will eventually break the social license of their industry and power us all into a renewable energy future.
As you can see, in Negros Occidental, we have a lot of history in fighting against this dirty energy and fighting against fossil fuels. What good would their 20-year-long fight be if we don't stand up for it as well? As long as there isn't an ordinance that would declare Negros fossil-free, coal-free, the fights would keep coming. If there would be a resolution that would prohibit San Miguel Corporation from entering San Carlos City, in a few years there'll be another fight, in a few years there'll be another fight. So we are hoping for our provincial legislators to pass an ordinance that would be sustainable and long-lasting beyond their terms and beyond our generation. Seeing the multiple generations worth of fight against dirty energy is very empowering. It's a good story to tell our children, our grandchildren in the future, if we are able to win this fight and be able to create a clean and green province for them.